So, I just left school, and you're not going to believe what happened. Oh, wait a second. Sorry. Anyways, this is a real disaster. I can't believe it. You won't believe it. Don't worry, I'm home. And I'm gonna give you all the details on today's video. See you in a minute. Y'all, I've been working so hard this year to get a perfect grade in math. And, well, I just got my latest test back. It's not good. I know, I should be happy with this grade. And I am happy, really. Except, well, it's still not a perfect grade. And y'all know I've taken every personality test available and always score a perfectionist with a wing of perfectionist. And here's the worst part. I only missed one question. I worked so hard this time. Okay, it's Joey 13 says, don't worry, Dot, nobody's perfect. Well, it's Joey 13. That's the question, isn't it? I mean, are we so certain that there's never been anyone who was perfect? What if there was? Then they could probably help me figure out how. I feel a mystery coming on. You know what that means. We've got a case to crack. Looks like we've got a missing persons case on our hands. We need to find a perfect person so they can help me know how to score a perfect grade in math. The first step in solving a mystery like this is research. The internet is a great place to start, but we've got to be careful with where we look, because not everything on the internet can be trusted. Wait, what? All of these links are about finding the perfect person to love. That's not what I want at all, ew! Let's try a different approach.
One of nature's perfect predators.
Okay, so here's the update. It sounds like nobody can agree on what it even means to be perfect, much less that any one person actually figured it out. But I don't give up that easy. Perfectionist, remember? Always score a perfectionist with a wing of perfectionist. Check this out. It's a video on having perfect shooting accuracy in soccer. And that made me think, if there's anybody that's close to being perfect, it's got to be someone who plays professional sports, right? It's time to take this case on the road. Hey everybody, I've got Michaela, my fellow investigator.
Best friend.
With me, and we're at a professional sport training and exercise facility.
A practice field.
To meet a professional sportsman.
Pro athlete.
And interrogate him.
Question.
What?
Question, not interrogate.
Fine. Question him about what it takes to be perfect at something.
Perfect.
Was it?
No.
You can't see him, but Alex is here too, documenting our investigation. Say hi, Alex.
Hey everybody.
I've got a really good feeling we're gonna find the clues we need inside. You ready? Let's go. This is Ryan Hollingshead, a professional soccer player with FC Dallas. Mr. Hollingshead, I'm investigating the existence of a perfect person, and I found a video about perfect shooting accuracy. Since you were the highest scoring defender in 2019, I assume your shooting accuracy is perfect?
It's pretty good, I think.
But you wouldn't say it's perfect.
I wouldn't say it's perfect. For every goal I score, there's three or four that I don't score.
I see. Ryan Hollingshead is not perfect.
Yeah, that's right, I'm not perfect. I've been practicing ever since I was 3 years old. Almost every day, and I've gotten better and better, but I am still not perfect. There's so much for me to work on.
So no matter how much you practice, you're still not perfect at it. And they still pay you.
Yeah, I guess so. Every athlete has to train, even the greats. There's not a single perfect player in any sport.
I don't get it. I thought of all the people in the world, professional sportsmen,
athletes,
would be the closest to perfection. But it doesn't sound like I'm getting any closer to finding a perfect person.
Well, I think I have some bad news for you. if you're looking for a perfect person, I don't think there's a single one out there. Except one.
What? Seriously?
Who?
Well, have you guys ever thought about Jesus? Have you guys ever thought about Jesus?
Have you guys ever thought about Jesus?
He was both human and he was perfect. Now, a lot of people thought that he was maybe just a good
teacher. Of course. This is unbelievable. How could I be so careless? I completely forgot to include Jesus as a possible, or maybe even the only probable candidate for the most perfect person who ever lived. Seriously, Dot, you're better than this. I know, right?
Is she okay?
She does this sometimes.
Thanks, Mr. Hollingshead. You've been a big help. But this case is about to crack wide open. Come on.
You're welcome. Glad I could help. And they're gone. Wait, aren't you supposed to go with them?
Oh, right.
Okay, so here's what we know. As far as regular human beings are concerned, there's never been a perfect person. But Jesus was perfect. If we're going to find his secret to perfection, I'm going to need to see everything he ever said or did.
So the Bible. Look, my small group leader at church has been doing a Bible study on the life of Jesus. What if we talk to her first? She might be able to give us more information about Jesus being perfect.
Great idea. We're one step away from solving this mystery. Let's roll.
Michaela, hi.
Hi, Jesse. These are my friends Dot and Alex, and we've got a question for you.
Alex, Dot, nice to meet you.
Hi, Jesse.
Miss Small Group Leader Jesse, can you confirm for us that Jesus was indeed a perfect person?
Yes, I can confirm that Jesus was indeed perfect.
Okay, so I've been really frustrated with trying to get a perfect grade in my math class, and I'm desperate for tips. Can you tell me how he did it?
Yeah, I mean, I could use a little help too. I always feel like my parents want me to be perfect, but I have no idea what that means.
I don't even try. Look around. It doesn't look like anybody else is perfect either.
These are no different than what any of us feel about failure. But instead of trying to find a secret to perfection, maybe it would help to understand why Jesus was perfect and what that means for us.
So Jesus was a real person, but he was also really God. He wasn't born with the sin nature that the rest of us are born with. It's that nature that keeps us from being perfect. Paul wrote that Jesus knew no sin. The author of the book of Hebrews wrote that even though Jesus was tempted just like we are, he never sinned. That's what I mean when I say he was perfect. Jesus lived a life of total obedience to God, and he had to for one really important reason.
Why smoke a latte with whip?
A what?
Yes, that's mine. Thank you. Sorry about the interruption. As I was saying, we are imperfect because of sin, and we are under a penalty for that sin, a penalty of death. Our only hope is for someone else, someone with no sin, to stand in our place. Because Jesus was perfect, he could, and he did for each and every one of us when he died on the cross. But then, and here's the cool part, Jesus didn't stay dead. He defeated death and came back to life. He did that so that every imperfect person who puts their trust and obedience in Jesus can be seen as perfect by God. In other words, we don't have to worry about being perfect because Jesus is perfect for us.
Wow. Thanks, Jesse.
So to sum up, in Dot's case, what you're saying is that it's okay she got that horrible grade in 92, right?
92? Girl, that's actually good.
That's what I said.
Miss Small Group Leader Jesse, this was exactly the evidence we've been looking for. You've been a huge help.
Wonderful. I'm glad I could be. If you have any other questions, please give me a call. Bye.
Bye.
Alex, you're the host. I think you need to hang up.
Oh, right.
Is that you?
Sorry, my mistake. Hanging up now.
We had quite a mystery on our hands, but by using helpful tools, asking the right questions, and following our gut, we got the answer. There was one perfect person who ever lived, and his name is Jesus. You know what? I think even I learned something today. I thought maybe I could figure out how to be perfect, but the truth is, I'm not, and that's okay. By trusting and following Jesus, I don't have to worry about being perfect, because he was perfect for me. I'm going for that 100, but even if I never make it, that's perfectly fine. I think we can close the book on this case, Webtectives.
Dot! Time's up! I need my laptop!
Oops, gotta go. Remember, the truth is out there. We've just gotta go find it. Catch you later.